I hope you have an amazing day. So I want to film this intro with my face showing, so it's a little bit more personal, so don't mind how I'm looking right now. I just got a shower and also got my comfy suit on, so I'm ready for bed. You can see the outside here, but I want to make it a little bit more personal. And if you like the intro like this, please let me know. So in this video I'm gonna do a review of a beautiful Efile I got on Shein for only $21 or $22, so it's really affordable, and I also made it my own. So I am trying some new stuff out, so I'm trying to use and get some chapters. So this video is a little bit longer, but I do have different chapters, like the review. I have a small Temu haul all related to a nail drill, the filing and the testing of the filing, because I took everything off of my nail, and at the end I have a sped up version of me putting everything of the bling and things on my e-file. So check that out. Also, I do want to mention I'm not English. Dutch is my main language, so if my videos appear a little bit boring and slow, please know I'm working on it. In my own language, I speak really fast. I make a lot of jokes and things like that. But in English, I also I want to educate you. See, there's all the struggle. But I want to teach you something. And also, I have to, in my head, I have to translate and then translate it to you. So I'm sorry for my robot voice throughout the videos. I really hope you can last throughout my videos. I really appreciate it if you go to the end of the video. It means a lot to me if you do, because videos will get better, but give me some time to make videos. I'm making up ways to make videos more interesting, more fun, and more like me, so I can speak English like I speak Dutch, because I have ADHD, so normally I speak really fast. I can be funny, you know, so I want to include that in my videos as well. So hopefully you will bear with me. I really appreciate it if you subscribe to my channel, because I want you to be part of this community, and also leave this video a thumbs up. And for now, enjoy the video, and I really, really hope you have an amazing day, an amazing weekend. Have fun. So here is the box with the e-file in it, and I got the pink one. This one came from Shein, and it's really affordable, so I want to try out an affordable nail file, because I'm currently I'm using my Bell e-file, and this was quite expensive. I got it for a review years ago, and I'm still using it, and you can see it's already scuffed up and everything, but it still says Bell here, and this is quite the expensive e-file. So I want to see if I could find an e-file and bits and everything for an affordable price, so everybody can buy it. I think the price was around 36 euros, I think. And we are going to see if it's worth its money, so you can buy it as well, because it wasn't that expensive. So it says a portable nail polisher, but that's okay. And it says it's white. It goes to 45,000 RPM, and my other e-file goes to 35 RPM. So that's the difference, because I know before, so years ago, they go to 30-35 RPM max, so that's something new. It's low noise, and it comes with a USB, and I really like the fact that it comes with a USB to charge it, because normally you will get a plug, and especially if you order somewhere that has a plug that you cannot use, because I'm in the Netherlands, and there you have the EU plug. So if I get a e-file with a USA plug, I always struggle in buying extra plugs so I can use it. So the fact that this one is with a USB, I freaking love it, because you can use it everywhere.
and also it is rechargeable. Same with my beautiful light that I have right here. There is some USB portals in here as well, so if I wanted to, I can charge my Efile with the lamp that I got here. So I want to show you the Efile, just see everything that's in here, noise, everything. Then I will go through the bag with everything I got from Temu that is related to this Efile, and then at the end of the video we're gonna give that Efile a test and take everything off here. And I also really like the fact that I wanna customize my own Efile. So you saw that my lamp is a blinged out lamp, and this one is not blinged out or anything, and I do have a lot of charms and everything with the cutest things on it. So I wanna fill this Efile up with all those charms. So that is for the end of the video. If I can make chapters and I can figure out how to do that, I will definitely do it, so you can go down and just press the chapter that you wanna see. So I'm still figuring everything out on YouTube and everything, so please bear with me. So we are going to open it up and see everything that it's inside. So you get your standard drills. This comes with basically every Efile that you get. So these are just bits you use for preps. Then you got this bit that you use for your sanding bands. So it's, you cannot have enough of this one, because if you lose one you will have an extra, because the ones with the sanding bands are always really handy to use. Then you have your nail drill machine product manual. So I'm not gonna read everything, but here you can see everything, and if you wanna read it for yourself you can pause the video. There you go. And then it comes with this cord, and I like the fact also that both sides are the same, so it doesn't matter which side you plug in into the drill or into the machine. So it's quite short, but it has a stretchy end, so love the fact that it has that. Then you have your hand piece. And the handpiece is quite heavy, it's metal and it's gray, it's just a boring color, but it's okay, but it's quite heavy, so it feels nice. Then you've got your charger, just your white cable, and a lot of chargers look like this. So if yours break down, a lot of other machinery has the same charging. Then we've got this plastic bit you put on the side, so you can put your handpiece inside. And then we have the Efile here. That's everything that is inside. So let me scoop aside the box. And here we have the drill. And this is really, really light. So it's pink, so I love the fact that it's pink. And it's really light. There is no way to it. So the other one, the bell one, is quite heavy, and this is really not really, really light. So you've got your clip here, so you can clip it somewhere aside, or you can clip it on your belt from your jeans. And then here you have the part you can put this thingy in, but you can there is one on both sides, so if you're left-handed you will put it on this side to make it easier, and if you're right-handed you put it on this side. So normally the other ones have just this part on the right side, so I love the fact that I put it on both sides, so for the lefties and the righties. I'm a right-handed girl, so I will put it on this side and just click it in, and it will get stuck there and it doesn't move anywhere. So we have some plastic on here, so let me get a little bit of an ASMR situation right here. A little bit disappointing, but okay. And then we have I love the fact that this is a really big. I will show you my other drill. So I have a clip here, so it's for forward and reverse, and this is also the knot that you turn it on and to control your speed. So that's everything on here, and I love the fact that it has a turn on and off button, also a pause button, and also a button that you can change the direction of filing. So if I do my non-dominant hand, I will turn it reverse, and if I do my if I'm working with my non-dominant hand, I will do reverse, and otherwise I will do it forward. Then here you have a USB plug, so that's really nice, so you can put extra things in here if you wanted to. If you have a little light that is USB powered, you can put it in here for extra lighting. Then here is the plug that you connect your handpiece with, and then this is for the charger. So we will see if it's charged already, and it is. It's almost completely full. So this is the RPM, and it's on forward because there is an F right here. Let me plug this in. So one side in this, and one side in this one. And there is no... Oh, you can open it and close it, but it doesn't say which way it's open or closed, but that's okay. I did get an extra bit on Shein as well, because I want to test it out as well, and I thought it was so freaking cute because it has a really cute pink rhinestone there, and also it got a little safety part right here. I did order more of these pink safety things. It's just a rubbery thing, just to protect your e-file. You can see it goes towards this part right here, and it just make sure you don't press your e-file too far in. So I really like that part, and I thought this was really cute. You do want to save this little piece right here, because if you have nothing in here with dust and everything or other things that get stuck in here, and then you cannot use your e-file anymore. So you want to save this part. So if you're not using it and there's no bit inside, you want to put this one back inside if you lay it aside. So we will see if it's noisy or not. So it's on 2. All the way. So for me, this is really quiet. I really like the fact that it's this quiet. I'm not gonna touch it because I will hurt myself, because it's for quite a coarse bit, but it's not noisy at all. I will get my other one and I will let you hear the difference. And this is the really expensive one for a couple of hundred. You can hear this is only 35 RPM. You can hear that, right? And then this one. It goes even faster. So with noise, I have nothing to complain about. I do really, really like it. So let me put this aside. And I want to see if the pause button does something. So we're going to put it on 21. And there it goes. It pauses. So I really like the fact that it pauses, because I do clients' nails and everything. So if I have to do something or clean something, I always lay my e-file down. But I have to turn it all the way back around so it doesn't move any more, because if you put it on the table while it's moving, it will go everywhere and it will destroy everything. So I really like the fact that it's have a pause button, because it's saving so much time. So, and if I go push play again, it will start back up. And also, if you want to go the other way, pause it, pull it the other way, perfect. You can see the reverses on this side. I really like this. I really do. I really like it. It's really cute. It's really light. And it's pink. So far, so freaking good. So, love this so far. I freaking love it. So, I'm gonna turn this off. And I will unpack the rest that I have to show you guys, but for now I'm just really excited, and I'm really curious to see if I can take everything off of my hand. So the rest I got from Temu, and they are all kind of nail drill related, but I also got some random stuff in here, so I want to show you those. So the first things I want to show you are some nail bits or drill bits that I got. And I saw these were pink, so I thought these would be perfect. And they all come in different courses. So you have your red, your blue, your yellow, your green, and this is a black. So it goes from fine to coarse. So I think this is the coarse one. And I will think it will go like this. Let me see if it's on here. No, it doesn't say which grid it is, but you can see on the file which course it is. Let me take it out of the package so I don't make too much noise. So we got five different courses. So we have got a yellow, and I think this is a fine one, and it goes all the way to coarse, and the most coarse one. You can see this is really fine. Just to rough up the surface of your nail, and then if you are using acrylics or really tough poly gels, you can use this. You can see the difference in those two. And then those three are in between. But I wanted to test them out. So you will see them throughout videos where I'm testing them. And I will test them also again at the end of the video in my new e-file to see how they work. I have five of them, and I do have five nails, so that's a convenient. So I got those. I got this, a really nice white box, so I was really happy about that. No, just kidding. Let me open this. And I thought this was also cute, handy, and really nice. So I will try and leave all the links down below if I can find it and if it's still available. So I got this little acrylic container, and this is to put your e-file in with some bits. You can see here, you can put your bits, you can put your e-file part in here, and here you can put your hand files. And I thought this was so freaking cute to put on my table, because now my e-file things are in a drawer. And I thought it was really handy, because you can put your e-file in here and leave it like this, and then you can put your little bits right there. And if you're doing your own nails or your client nails or anything, it looks cute on your table. I got a pinkish purple one. And also, you have some easy access, and it's really easy to clean out and everything. So I thought this was genius to have. And also, you can put your extra instruments or anything that you relate to your e-file, you can put in here. I can put my handpiece in there, and I thought this was fantastic. Really perfect for my table. And you know, I'm trying to get everything pink on my table. I'm saving up for a pink chair, so I love this. So we have a pink e-file, we've got some pink bits, and then also a pink container. So freaking love it. So the next item that I got is this, and I also thought this was really cute. So I'm gonna show you something. I do have a little container with some nail bits and everything, and I thought this was so really not organized. I have this, just a little container. I have this, an extra little container. And again, another little container. So I have bits and bobs everywhere. And then I saw this. I saw this on Temu, and they had a fantastic deal for me, so I had to have it. So we've got an ASMR situation here again. There we go. Look at this. Look how cute. It's pink, it's sparkly. I freaking love it. It comes with a clip, and then we are opening it. And also, if you have extra bits, you can put them inside, and if you close it, you can see what you have. Look at this. Look how cute. Look how freaking cute. And I love the fact that I can put it on my table, because all the other stuff is in my drawer, and it's not nice to put a little container there and just put everything in. Now I have everything nice and freaking organized. So love that. I love this haul. I really love this haul. Then I got this, and I do have a lot of cuticle pushers, but I didn't have this. So I always file my nails off, then I will soak the rest off, but I didn't have anything to scrape them off. I used the cuticle pusher to get everything off, but I saw that, I will show you the cuticle pusher that I normally use. This is one of the cuticle pushers that I use, and this part is quite sharp. And oh, my drink is in. My monster was waving at you, but this part is quite sharp, and it destroyed my nails, because I'm quite hard on myself, and I was scraping and doing crazy things. And this is quite rounded, and it's not sharp, so you can use this to scrape off any excess. And this is much harder to stab yourself or cut yourself with. So I thought this would be perfect also if I'm doing it on clients or anything. I think this is more safe to use than the cuticle pusher. So this is also really nice to put right there, so I can keep everything together. So the last items that I got are not e-file related, but it came in this package. So I wanted to show you the last three things that I got. So these are nail charms, and I think they are so freaking adorable. So I will spill them out on the table and show you. I thought these were so freaking cute. Look at those. We have some different colors here, and they look, whoo, I'm slippery. Look how cute. They are little ones with wings, and they really remind me of the Sailor Moon things. So I thought those were so freaking cute. So I got a pack of these. Then I got a pack of these cuties right here. And you know, I already did a full set of donut nails, but I thought these were much cuter. So you got a bunny donut. We've got this little guy right here. And we have different colors, sizes, no, not sizes, but shapes and everything. And I thought these were so freaking cute. So I got a little pack of those. Look how adorable. I freaking love it. And then I got these. And and these are little duckies. And if you saw my other video, you know I already have some duckies, but somehow I always order duplicates because I think I don't have them, and I do. And then the last item in this are these, and I don't know what they are, but I thought they were adorable. So these are little sticks. They look like barbecue sticks or Japanese thingies, but I thought they were looking so freaking cute, and they were sitting in my basket for a while, and I thought I just have to have them. So I thought they were really cute for a cute set for the summer, for barbecue nails or anything else. And if you know what these are, let me know. So far that was everything that I got buying. So now we are going to take off my piggy nails, and I don't want to take them off because I think they are so freaking cute, but I have to because I do want to create some new news for you guys, because everybody is coming with amazing ideas like do bee nails, do this, do that, and I think all your ideas are so freaking amazing that I want to do all of them. But now I do have to take my piggy butt off, and I don't want to, but I have to. So see you in a second. It is time, the moment is here. We are going to take these off. So first I'm gonna use these nippers. Look at this cute paw, to take my little stones off, and also these charms, because you don't want to use that with an e-file. You want to use these nippers, and you want to make sure you're not nipping towards your skin, always other directions, because I know from experience, if you nip and something goes wrong and you will slide over your nail or just slip or anything, these are so freaking sharp, you will hurt yourself. You really hurt yourself. Aww. And the piggy is still good, so I love the fact that it's still usable. Only on myself. So look how easy this goes. If you have the right nippers, these come off really easy. And with the Maccart glue, everything stayed on perfectly. So if everything is off, I will get the bigger one, and then I will cut my nails from both sides. Make it a little bit shorter before filing it. So this is the process I'm gonna do for all of these nails. I'm gonna take the piggy ass off, and all the piggy charms, and all the small charms, and then I will cut them before filing everything. So let me do that off camera, and then I will be back filing these babies off. So they are all off. If you are filing your nails, you wanna have a dust collector. And if you have some, you want to put a mouthpiece for your mouth and nose, so you don't inhale any dust that comes off from these nails. Also, if you're doing client nails and everything, make sure you have a dust collector. They are really cheap. This is one that also comes from Shein as well, and it was really affordable. But there will be a Shein haul coming online soon where I showcase all of these items with prices and everything for all the beginners out there. So I have a glove on this, put a mouthpiece for, and put these on. I do have the bit with the little diamond on. I'm gonna use this to take this off. So let me put my dust collector on, and I will speed this part up because the noise is not that nice. So So I filed my nails until I saw this white, and that is another base coat. So you saw maybe some different colors. So you had my color on top, the tip, then the pink stuff that I put on my nail to glue those tips on, and this is a base coat. So if I see white during filing, then I will stop filing, because the rest of this I will soak off. So I will be laying on the couch in a second, soaking these babies off. So you can see here inside this dust collector, how many dusts there is inside. Look how much there is. So I will take a vacuum and vacuum this out until it's clean. But if you're not using a dust collector, you can see how much dust there will be flying in the air and around you. So that's something you don't want. So make sure you use a dust collector. So in total, it took me like 10 minutes to do all of these nails until this part. So perfect. Also, I saw that it stopped when you put too much pressure on it, because you want to make sure if you use a nail file, you leave the work to the nail file, so you don't press too hard. Because also using those on clients, you can create heat spots, so a burning sensation on the nail, and that's something you don't want. You don't want to destroy the natural nail or make it too thin. So you do want to make sure you have it on a high enough RPM, so if you file it without putting any pressure, it will take the product off. You don't want to put any pressure on the nail. So for this is the part of the evaluation and review of this e-file. I think I will use it a lot in these videos because I freaking love it, and look how adorable it is. Now it's not finished yet. I do want to bling out this part, and also I have extra new bibs and bobs and charms and everything. I want to fill the sides as well, and maybe the on off button as well. But we will see how far we will come, and I will keep you updated into my video. So this was another chapter. If you are still here, thank you so much for watching. For now, I'm gonna say enjoy your day. Make sure you subscribe, leave the thumbs up on the video, and have a really, really nice weekend. And if you have to work through the day, make sure you do it with a laugh. And I will see you on my next one. Bye.